Assembly. We really hope that you have all enjoyed the first Animal Advocacy Conference Asia as much as we did. We really enjoyed it ourselves. I know most of you are familiar with the jazz hands now, but please give us some jazz hands if you have enjoyed the AACA so far. Thank you so much. Thank you. That's so good to see. Let us introduce some of the faces that the AACA team members who have been working behind the scenes in the last 2 weeks. So over to you, Alia.
Hello, this is Alia. I'm from Pakistan. I'm the country rep and a volunteer for AACA. Over to you, Angel.
Thank you, Alia. My name is Angel. I am the grants coordinator for the conference and I'm based in Hong Kong. And then we have Charles.
Hi, everyone. I'm the technical coordinator. I'm also in Hong Kong right now.
My name is Kaho and I'm based in Japan and I'm a country representative for Japan.
Thank you, Kaho. So my name is Ellie. I am from Japan. I'm based in the UK. My role is a program coordinator for the conference. And yeah, thank you so much for joining us. Over to you, Mimi.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mimi and I'm a country representative from Myanmar. And I'm currently in Myanmar at the moment as well. In addition to all of us, we also have over 30 volunteers who are helping us at the moment, who are working tirelessly behind the scenes to make this happen. You know who you are. Thank you very much. Over to you, Angel.
Thank you, Mimi. So the first ever AACA 2020 has finally come to an end, and we are so thankful to every one of you who made this possible, including all of you who are attending, our speakers, our sponsors, ProVeg and Veg Fund, and our volunteers. We couldn't have achieved this without you.
Now I'd like to introduce hand signals. I'm sure most of you are familiar with it by now. We want to encourage the participants to use this jazz hand to show your agreement or excitement for what is being shared and discussed. It is quite encouraging for everyone in this session to be able to see such positive reactions from everybody. We also have a breakout room in this session where participants can share what they've learned in the workshops they've attended. In the breakout room, please use this hand signal pointing up to signal that you would like to speak. This way we can avoid interrupting each other and make sure everybody has a chance to speak. Now I'd like to take 1 minute of silence. Before we start, we'd like to join us in taking a minute to remember why we're all here. Please find a comfortable position and close your eyes if you feel comfortable doing so. Let's take a minute of silence. We remember those who were born in captivity and cruelty.
We 出生就被囚禁、被残忍对待的动物.
We remember those who are oppressed under speciesism.
我们记得那些受到物种歧视压迫的动物.
We remember those who share this planet with us.
我们记得与我们共享这个星球的动物.
We are here in solidarity for those who want to live in freedom.
我们为那些希望自由生活的动物团结一致.
We are here in solidarity for those whose voices are ignored, even when they resist.
我们为那些即使反抗、声音也被忽略的动物团结一致.
We come together for a better world for all.
我们团结在一起，为所有生灵创造更美好的世界.
You may open your eyes now. Thank you very much for taking 1 minute of silence with us.
Right now, before we start our breakout rooms, we will have a little takeaway session from the team and anyone who would like to join us. I'll be sharing my input. So for me, one of my best takeaways was during Rio D's presentation on how to talk about veganism without being pushy and awkward on the first day. And during that presentation, he talked about reciprocity when channeling activism with non-vegans and to listen to them openly and attentively to what they have to say, and then respond collectively and calmly. In that way, they would be more open to hear what we have to say and also communicate with us on the activism as well. So that is one of the best takeaways that I have. And over to you, Elia.
Thank you, Mimi, for sharing your insight. For me, definitely, it was Sujay Kumar's importance of nonviolence and how he, at one part, talks about using terminologies, specific terminologies like free roaming instead of wildlife. So that was very inspiring for me. What was your favorite takeaway from the workshop? What would you apply to your advocacy? What else do you want to learn next year from us? And what did you like the most about our conference? So, and plus, if you come up with something else, do discuss that. It's a 10-minute session, so I hope you guys enjoy it.
Thank you, everyone. We trust that you had a fruitful and reflectional discussion. Now we would like to invite some representatives to share your takeaways on the conference.
Hi, I'm Rachel from Group 2. And for the first question that... Hi, I'm sorry, Big Rain here. And the favorite takeaway is Katrina thinks that Ruji Chua, it was kind of interesting that she taught us that we need to think from the victim perspective. And Manya said that self-care talk, that it is also quite interesting as we always forgot we need to self-care and care for our self and our body and soul. So it is quite interesting for us to relax ourselves. And well, for the future talks that they hope is, Katrina hope that fundraising is something that she hopes to can understand more. I'm not sure if you guys hear me because my connection is not really that stable. And thanks. And Haru said she would like to know more about sanctuaries. And for Fahila and me, we were both from Malaysia, and we really hope that there are Malaysian networking hours next year so we can know vegans from our country. And everyone's agreed that we like this conference as everyone is really, really friendly and we get to talk to each other and network. So we really all love this talk. Thank you so much, AACA. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rachel, and to your group support and constructive feedback. And yeah, we really hope to have more country-oriented networking sessions in the next year to do so. And we really appreciate all the support that all of you have been giving until now with all the sessions and the networking hours as well. So thank you. Thank you to all of you. Would anyone else like to speak?
Hi there.
Okay. Craig and George. Hello. Craig, go ahead.
From Group 3. Thank you very much. Yeah, so we had some takeaways shared that, you know, my favorite takeaway from the conference was that in the group by the session by Witch Peromsan from Synergy at Animal, you know, I was saying that a good lesson is that Synergy at Animal are a vegan organization who promote an abolitionist approach of consumption reduction. And that, for me personally, is the method that I adhere to and stand by. But what Witch was saying is that even though they promote that method, they still understand the benefit of the work of the welfare improvement work that they're doing in the meantime, because, you know, these billions of hens, they can't wait around for us to promote veganism. So my big takeaway is that in this challenge of helping animals, there is no black and white, there's a lot of gray area, and some of the others agreed with that in the group. In terms of what we would apply to advocacy in the future, Anne-Sophie said that she would definitely think about taking a different and possibly more subtle approach when she's advocating on social media, for example, or in person, and just changing her approach to be not as aggressive or forceful. Albert said that what works in one place may not necessarily work in another, or with one person might not work with another. And so he said that, you know, we have to try various methods. And he also said we should put ourselves in the other person's shoes when advocating. And I think that's a fantastic point. In terms of how this will help Inami from Japan's advocacy, she said that this is her first time learning about particular organizations in Japan. And now following the conference, she'll be able to immediately go and help them, you know, to maybe volunteer or engage with them. And that's something that she didn't know before. So that's a massive benefit. In terms of what other things we'd like to see in the future, our group agreed that, you know, a lot of the sessions have been focused around the element of advocating, which is like the one-to-one vegan, you know, influence that you have as humans to humans. And maybe in future years, we could see more sessions, even though there were some sessions that focused on industrial scale strategies, maybe there would be more sessions like that in the future that can help inform us about what are the global scale strategies that we can undertake to solve these problems. In terms of what our group said that we liked about the conference, we said that it's been extremely well organized and delivered. That the sessions have been ordered in a really clear way that's easy for everyone to understand and access, and it's just been extremely well executed. So thank you to the organizers for that. And that's it from our group. Thank you.
Thank you, Craig. From what you elaborated, I felt like you and your team has learned a lot and also gave us valuable takeaways for us and encouragement, and that means a lot to us, and we hope that you all could join us again next year. Hello, George.
Okay, all set. Yeah, so I'm from group one, and just like the other groups, we thought the program was very well organized, and we really liked the feeling of respect among all the participants. We felt that it was a good opportunity to learn about different things happening in Asia. Like, about one person said the activism in China was very surprising and happily surprising for her. We liked the talk about burnout and mental health. We think that's very important to continue. We hope that in the future we can have more good news, people sharing the good things that they're doing, but we don't want to forget the problems that we encounter. More on communication skills, more on how to connect local groups, because there might be several groups working in the same country or even the same city, but they don't coordinate as much as they should. And then another topic would be alternative protein, you know, like Impossible, Beyond, and this cell-based meat. Thank you.
Thank you, George.
We actually had applications from individuals and organizations to speak at our conference that unfortunately we couldn't accommodate this year. But if you're interested in speaking at our conference next year, please do write to us at info@aaconference-asia.com. I think the email address is being shared right now. We will register your interest for next year and we will get back to you when we can. So yes, please do get in touch with us if you want to speak at our conference next year.
We are a nonprofit organization run by volunteers, and please consider supporting us. By donating, you will enable us to do more educational events like this conference in Asia. So you can support us from the link which will be shared in the chat box. And thank you so much for those who have already supported us by donating. We couldn't have made the conference like such a success without you. So thank you so much. And we are looking for more volunteers to join our team to help us reach more people in wider Asian region. If you want to join us as a volunteer or any organization who wants to collaborate with us in the future, email us at the same email address, info@aaconference-asia.com. I think it was shared in the chat box already. So please reach out to us via email or our social media.
So we do have four organizations today with us who would like to share their projects with us. Thank you, George.
Okay, sure. Can everyone see my screen? Great. So about 10 years ago, I attended a conference in Singapore called Animals for Asia. And what really stands out about this year's conference compared to back then is how almost everybody is vegan or at least pro-vegan. And that's so different from how it used to be. So it's really heartening to see that kind of change. So I'm going to talk about a program that Vegan Outreach does, but I know that other organizations do very similar programs. Like there's Veganuary and Synergia has a program like this. So I'm not saying this program is better. I'm just saying maybe there's some ideas that people can learn. So there's this organization called Vegan Outreach, which has been around since the 1990s. They started in the US, but now they're in many other countries. And their main method was going to universities and or concerts, things like that, and passing out flyers. But of course, now they can't do that because of COVID. So I think they've done a very good job of adjusting. I'm not really part of that organization, but I helped them to do 10 weeks to vegan in Singapore. So I'll show you a list of countries in Asia where 10 weeks of vegan is already happening. So the way it works is for 10 weeks, you sign up every week, you get an email. And there's also a Facebook group to discuss. So it's already happening in India, Japan, Singapore, Indonesia, South Korea, and Taiwan. And it's under development in Philippines, Turkey, and Vietnam. So if it's not happening in your country, you can contact Vegan Outreach and they can help you. So each email that comes once a week has the following sections. Firstly, they spotlight one animal and they talk about how that animal is a sentient being and what happens to that animal in factory farming. Then there's always something about nutrition. So beef is associated with protein. So they talk about protein and how on a plant-based diet, we can get all the nutrition we need. So those two sections are for every country, although it would be translated for a place like Japan. Then we have local recipes, and that's what the people in each country do. We have local recipes, like let's say the week about cows, we have things that taste like beef. Like in Singapore, we have rendang. Then we have eateries where you can get vegan food. Lots of them in Singapore, but there's also non-vegan restaurants that have tasty vegan dishes. Then stores. What vegan items can you get from supermarkets, specialty shops? We just recently had a vegan grocer open in Singapore. And of course, there's online grocers. Then something unique that we did in Singapore is to have each week a vegan hero, somebody in Singapore who is doing great things for animals and to spread vegan. This person, her name is Anbu. She runs a shelter for animals who were trafficked. You know, like turtles, they kidnap them from one place, they bring them to Singapore, or Singapore is a transshipment place. So it's a great thing to do. And thank you for your time.
Thank you so much, George, for your presentation. So let's move on to the next organization.
Perfect. So thanks very much to the organizers for a fantastic event once again. It's just been great. And thanks very much for the opportunity to say a couple words. I'm just going to very quickly let you know about joining the AFA network. And whilst this slide is on the screen, please feel free to take a screenshot to get our email address. That's afacoalition@gmail.com. Because we'd love to hear from you if you have an NGO which is interested in learning more about our work or being supported by us or supporting our work in the appeal letters that we do. I also just want to say, whilst this slide is on the screen, to give you a little time to screenshot that if you like, that the area of working with farm animals is a new thing for Asia for Animals Coalition, and it's a new opportunity that we have, and I'm really delighted to be the farm animal coordinator, because it's not a big area that we worked on before. And I just want to say that, you know, this AACA conference that we've been enjoying this last couple of weeks is isn't just focused on farm animals. It's about all animal advocacy, but because they're the biggest group of animals, and we're focusing on veganism and diet change, that is a natural consequence that farm animal group comes out of that. And but Asia for Animals also has, like, for example, a macaque coordinator as well, because macaques are a big group in Asia that need attention. And George mentioned our conference that he's been to in Singapore 10 years ago. That's great. It's the longest running conference for animals in Asia. And we've covered all sorts of topics. The most recent one was law. We cover human behavior change. So we're just reiterating that we're not just a farm animal organization, but that is my area of work. So basically how AFA is set up is that we have 23 official members, which some of them are household names that you will be familiar with, WAP and Born Free and Big Cat Rescue, RSPCA, you know, so all of these well-known organizations. And basically what happens is we have a network of 300 organizations at the moment. A lot of those are grassroots groups on the ground in Asia. And what they can do is add their signature to our appeal letters. And we typically send about 2 appeal letters a month to governments on a wide range of issues. And then, as you can see from this diagram here, in return for their support, we can give them support. So I just want to iterate what kinds of things we can do for your NGO. Joining our network is absolutely free, and we can support you with mainly networking, events, and help with strategies. I've already, you know, mentioned that we have a database of 300 organizations, and there's a private area of our website that you can use for networking. Also, our conference is a great place to network. We have not only the biggest conference in Asia and the longest running, but this year we've also started to support a farm animal event called World Day for Farmed Animals on October 2nd. That was established in 1983 by FARM USA, Farm Animal Rights Movement. So we're getting more and more involved in that. And furthermore, we hope that in future years there can be an opportunity for us to support AACA as well. That would be fantastic. And, you know, so if your NGO has anything that you need help with on doing more effective work for farm animals in Asia, then these are the ways we can support you. And I just want to let you know that you can find out everything you need to know about this at asiaforanimals.com/join-AFA. So, and again, I'll leave this slide here for a couple of seconds if anyone wants to screenshot that, but it's asiaforanimals.com. And thanks again for the opportunity to speak. Thank you.
That's good. Okay, so I will talk more about international, which is where I work. And we also have this project called Food Fight Community, and it's all about, so Food Fight is a Slack workspace. Slack is an app for a computer or for a smartphone, which is very easy to download, and it's kind of a communicator which we use to communicate with other plant-based campaigners, and it's a workspace for all the people working volunteering in plant-based campaigns. So not animal welfare campaigns, but more the campaigns that promote plant-based or vegan diet. But we do not really limit ourselves to one kind of advocacy, and are very open to different kinds, because that is the thing that creates the change. And right now on this communicator, we have more than 300 activists from all around the world. They are from 50 organizations, over 30 countries on almost continents, and gives us a really good chance to collaborate internationally, create some cool projects together. And I will give you an example of one project that was successfully, that was possible thanks to this workspace. And this project is Chefs for Change International. And it's a project about, it's a project connecting the cooks and the chefs from all around the world that think that plant-based cooking is important to create a change. And we have chefs from right now from Europe, from Africa, from South America, from Asia. So, and it's still growing. So if you are interested, please reach out to me if you want to maybe make this work in your country too. But this was possible thanks to this Slack workspace where we can really talk to each other every day and work on the projects together. This is only one example of the project that we made. And you can join the community by pasting this link here or just scanning the QR code. And it's really simple. You just click on the website, join Food Fight, then you have a really, really short type form, which you just fill, and then you can join the workspace. We have really quite a lot of channels there regarding different kinds of campaigning. So we have channels for corporate outreach, for social media, for institutional outreach, some rankings, reports, resources, also food industry events, and quite a lot more. So you are more than welcome to join the workspace. It would be really, really, really nice to have you on board. And let's stay in touch. And this is my contact information, but I think the best way to reach me would be on Food Fight Slack, because then we can stay in touch like every day. It's really easy to speak. And yeah, this is, I think that's it from me.
And then I can share the links on the Facebook group, which is just better. So yeah, briefly, I just want to introduce myself. So my name is Laura. I've been working in the animal movements for over a decade. And currently I work for Anima International as a project management manager. And I focus on capacity and movement building. So basically, one of the things that we do at Anima International is that we look to empower and support people around the world. So we're not looking to open new chapters in new countries, but we focus on supporting local activists in neglected regions and providing them with information, resources, and inspiration that they need. So one of the several ways we want to do this is through this platform, and it's animainternational.org/resources. So if you go onto these resources, basically you will find a browsing option where you can look through webinars, footage of investigations, videos, articles, and guides. And you have from how to send a press release to how to do analytics on your website, footage of investigations of caged eggs, to fur farming, to pigs and other factory animals. And the main reason, or one of the reasons we created this, is because at our organization, where we work in different regions, including different countries within Eastern Europe and Scandinavia, we have encountered several bottlenecks, and we understand that if we can share all the materials and tools that we have been able to build up till now for free, and learn at the same time from other activists of how they use these resources and materials, we can then apply these modifications and then targeted specifically to the region. So one of the examples I want to give you is, for example, like you're doing a campaign related to caged eggs, and you just need some footage. And sometimes asking other organizations or groups give you limited usage. So what you can do on the platform is you can download the material for free. You can edit it, you can modify it as ever you want. You can stick your logo on it and you can use it for campaigning, use it for fundraising. Like once you've downloaded, it's your material and you're allowed to use it within the animal advocacy movement as you wish. And the highlight is that we want this platform to be interactive. So one of the things is that we also want to learn from the people that are using it. So it's still on beta stages and we're still testing, but we're doing a lot of follow-ups, which means that we want the people who are using and downloading and reading these materials, which they believe can be modified or more precisely focused on their region, to learn from it and then upload it so other people from that want to do similar campaigns or are also in the country can use these modified or new strategies. So we see it as a full circle. So we share for free, you can download it. And at the same time, we learn from you and we can upload it for future activists and groups within the movement. So just finishing up, basically, if you have, I will share, as I said, the platform on the Facebook group and I can share it also on the chat. And if you want to go onto the platform, search, and I would encourage you to look at the materials. And if you have any feedback of materials that you would rather have on the platform or any resources or tools that you think you would benefit from, I highly encourage you to let me know. I'll also give my contact details. And hopefully with this and what we want to create is a system in which we all help each other, where collaboration and networking we have seen for the last 2 weeks is super important, and that we can all create a better movement and grow together. So thank you very much again for the opportunity. I'm sorry I couldn't share my screen, and yeah, hopefully see you guys soon, if not another event, also in person. So thank you.
Thank you so much, Laura, for that.
Thank you, Ellie. I will be really quick. So if you haven't already, please follow us on social media. Tech team, please paste the link in the chat box. You can stay up to date with our future events. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. We will upload our translated recordings with subtitles to the platform so that we can all revisit these wonderful workshops. If you have any posts about us, please tag us on social media so we can reshare them. And we would appreciate it really much if you can help us spread the word in your community and share with other your peers, vegan friends, activists, friends, what you've learned in the past 2 weeks. We would also encourage you to join our email list or newsletter so you can stay up to date with events from Animal Alliance Asia. And don't worry, we won't spam you. You can sign up to our newsletter via our website. So all of these relevant links should be in the chat box now. And as Ellie has mentioned, we have a Facebook group. Please do join it. We have more and more people joining, and it's really exciting to see the discussion continuing over in the Facebook group. So please join the group, and please be reminded to also abide by our code of conduct and try to make a safe space for everyone on there as well. So I think that's it for me, and Aelia, over to you. Thank you.
Hello. Now, as we proceed towards the ending of our session, I want to introduce Aditi, who is from India. She's a songwriter and a singer, and she will leave us with some beautiful music. Please, if you're enjoying the session, give her jazz hands and waves and enjoy so that we all can share community spirit. Over to you, Aditi. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Aelia, for such a beautiful introduction. So the song that I'm going to sing is Imagine by John Lennon. I hope you all enjoy it.
Imagine there's no heaven. isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion too. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you will join us. And the world will be as one. Imagine no possession. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the wealth you know. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you will join us.
Thank you, Aditi, for a wonderful performance, and thank you for sharing your music with us. Over to you, Ellie. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Aditi and Alia. So we're coming to an end of the closing assembly, and we would love to take group photos, if that's okay with you all.
Okay. Done.
Thank you so much, Charles, and thank you so much, everyone, for your patience. So that's the end of our closing assembly. Thank you so much, everyone, for staying until the end, and we really hope you enjoyed our conference. This was our first conference ever, so we wouldn't have been able to make this happen without any of you. So thank you so much for attending. And we will definitely keep updating you all on social media platforms and newsletter on new events that are happening soon. So please stay tuned on these channels. And a big goodbye from all of our teams. Thank you so much for attending.